I grew up on Long Island, which is right across the sound from Yale School of Public Health. And in my childhood, there were a lot of news stories about cancer clusters on Long Island, breast cancer in particular. And people had a lot of ideas speculating what the causes were. Pesticides, PCBs, maybe the above ground power lines. So I was really struck by the amount of uncertainty in understanding the etiology of these cancer clusters. Environmental epidemiology is disease detective work, where we try to figure out clues that may explain whether or not exposure to environmental chemicals may cause health problems in the population. One of the most important and challenging aspects of environmental epidemiology is exposure assessment. This involves trying to determine who was exposed to which chemicals, at what levels, or how long, and how often. It's really important to get this right, to have accurate and precise exposure measures, because it can dramatically enhance our ability to observe a relationship between exposures and disease. Traditional environmental epidemiology typically looks at one chemical or small number of chemicals at a time, whereas there's growing recognition that this does not reflect the real world situation. Typically, we're exposed to hundreds of different environmental chemicals in our environment. And my work tries to address this by understanding the complex mixture of exposures to multiple chemicals over space and time. The project that I'm working on involves flame retardant chemicals. Flame retardants are added to household items like furniture, carpeting, electronic devices, so that they burn more slowly. Unfortunately, these compounds don't stay within these products. They migrate out into the dust in our homes and offices and cars, and we can be exposed to them through that pathway. These chemicals look remarkably similar to the naturally occurring thyroid hormone, thyroxin, and there's a hypothesis that this could, in addition to perturbing the thyroid hormone system, could possibly lead to thyroid cancer. So in our study, we are using the exposure tool of biological monitoring to measure flame retardant chemicals in people's blood and urine, and examining whether that increases the risk of thyroid cancer in Connecticut. Second project that I'm working on involves unconventional oil and gas development, which is commonly referred to as hydraulic fracturing or fracking. In this process, millions of gallons of water and chemicals are pumped deep below ground under very high pressure, breaking open rock and releasing natural gas or oil. My research team and I just completed a study this summer in Ohio in a community with active unconventional gas development. We were concerned about potential pollution from air or water, so we used environmental measurements to examine people's exposures. We collected water samples inside their homes, air samples inside and outside their homes, and we also are modeling how close people are to this oil and gas activity.